start, I want to tell you a little bit about the Ajay Devgan Rohit Shetty collaboration. This is one of Bollywood's most successful actor-director relationships. Rohit Shetty has made 10 films, 9 of which have starred Ajay Devgan. Ajay Devgan has 4 films in the 100 Crore Club. 3 of those were directed by Rohit Shetty. The films they've done together have grossed over 450 crores. So this is a really fruitful collaboration here.
Where's the money?
You haven't seen it?
He certainly made us realize.
They're the producers.
Both of you are going to go on for the producers now. This started 23 years ago. You were 16 years old.
Yeah.
And it's just amazing. What did you first like about each other?
You never thought
actually,
about
it. Actually, yeah, it didn't start like this. You can't decide that, okay, this is what hit us off together. It was just gradually, and it's been too, it's too late in
time.
Yeah, too late in time to even if somebody asks us that.
Like.
Now, both of you are also second generation Bollywood, but you did not come from that sort of Bollywood royalty of the Chopras and the Kapoors. Your fathers were fight directors, and you've both seen a fair amount of struggle and the sort of the other side of the very glamorous showbiz industry that we have. Do you think that has enabled you, in a sense, to have a better connect? Rohit, you talk about how you know what the masses are and therefore you can make films that connect with them in sort of 7 successive movies. You know, do you think that enables you?
Yeah, the connect with the common man is very important. That's what we are losing now. I'm talking about the industry or the critics. You'll go to a Starbucks, you'll meet like-minded people. And then you will feel bad and you will support PETA and you will support Stray Dogs. But if a Nariyal Pani Wala is liking the film, you say, oh, it's masi. It's hypocrisy.
What do you mean?
Yeah, you guys look down upon masi films. What is mass? They are poor people, so it's a bad film? It's not.
Well, you know, to defend critics.
No, again, if you're saying that, how you all escape? Due respect to Mr. Yash Chopra, I saw your review of Jab Tak Hai Jaan. You said, where will a waiter fall in love with a multimillionaire? Okay, it will fall in Yash Chopra's world. Why can't cars fly in Rohit Shetty's world?
Absolutely. No, they can, and they do. Very successfully, they keep flying.
So there's a kind of hypocrisy. There's a kind of that we are intellectuals. There is that. And it is sad. If Michael Bay is flying 1,000 cars in one film, it's fine.
But
if Rohit Shetty is doing 20 cars, it's trashy, it's massy. Oh,
Rohit, God. Michael Bay gets beat up constantly by critics in the West.
So you can call me the Michael Bay of India then.
Absolutely. Okay, so you had this connect with the common man, but as you get more and more surrounded by the bodyguards, by the 7 hits, by the 100 crores, do you not lose it? How do you keep it? How do you keep it, Ajay?
I think we still have the connect with our team.
Yeah,
we have not.
We don't have people around us telling us, giving us wrong facts.
Wrong facts, and it's like, you know, most of them have.
And we've been here 23 years. We've seen ups and downs.
Ups and downs.
We've seen everything possible and things changing. So, so we don't take anything for granted any which ways.
And I think we have that open door policy where even our production boy or our driver can come to us and say it's not working.
Yeah, give a comment.
Give a comment. That's what we
have.
Yeah, we have that. Even when my first cut is ready, we all see the film with our office boys also. And then we have a discussion that what they feel.
But they are honest?
They are honest.
You know, it all depends on you, what kind of people you want around you. And they also know that does he want to hear the fact or does he not?
Right.
And that's how he's trained.
There's no 100% guarantee of going right every time. But that's how we try to keep a connect with our audience.
Ajay, on Coffee with Karan, you gave a message for Rohit and you said that I'm so happy that people who abused your kind of movies want to work with you now. Is there a class system within Bollywood? Did you guys ever face that?
No, because I've heard people talking about that, including Golmaal, that is thrash cinema. And when the same people go and sign him, then you realize that they realize that thrash cinema is what they need right now, and that is what works to survive. So that was my message to those people.
Do you feel good, Rohit?
No, it's not an I don't have that arrogance or ego about it, but I feel good that I have lived up to my conviction that what I wanted to make, I'm doing. I'm catering my audience, and now gradually people are joining me and saying, okay, he's not doing anything bad. He's not a bad guy. Suddenly, for a few years, I was like...
You were a bad guy.
That's what the elite crowd thought of me. I don't know why. Okay, you know, like I was like Amitabh Bachchan of Diwar, and they all were Shashi Kapoor, and the critics were Nirav Pora. But at the end of that, I am Amitabh Bachchan. But at the end of that, I am Amitabh Bachchan, the bad guy. So all you need is a Shashi Kapoor, good film, message oriented, nice, Mera Beta. I'm the bad guy.
No longer. But you also said that when you see films like Rang De Basanti or Three Idiots, you said that I feel that I don't have a formal education and maybe I can never make movies like this. Ajay, do you think that's true? Can he not make movies like this, and should he aspire to make those films in the first place?
No, today he feels he can, he should. But till he mentally is not prepared to make such films, then he shouldn't, because there should be a certain kind of conviction to make certain films. And I'm sure the day he feels like doing something like that, I think he'll be able to pull it off very well.
So he sees these shortcomings, but you don't?
No, I don't. I don't.
Rohit, I've seen you at award functions. Ajay, you haven't been to one in 15 years. How come?
Because I don't believe in them, because I know for a fact how it works.
What do you mean?
And I know, don't ask me what you mean, because you know exactly what I mean. Okay, you can't say it.
You also act very well. Yeah. I should cast you in one of my movies.
So you exactly know how
it works.
Nirupara.
So that's the main reason I don't go for, because it's there are how many awards are there? The countless awards, and their criteria is not giving awards. Their criteria is to have a show which is sold on a television as software. And to have that software and to get more money out of it. It's like filmmaking. You need as many actors as possible. So either you create so many awards, or what you do is you find out who is coming, and they tell you that if you will come, then we'll give you this award, or we can give you that award. So is that award fair? Do I have to waste time to go there? Because at the end of the day, what am I feeling if I get that award also? Nothing, that I just went, attended or performed. I've got this award. There's nothing more to it. So I don't believe in it. I have 23 years of my career. Whatever little bit of success I have, it's always been on my terms and conditions, and it always will be. And nothing's going to change that.
But you're not seduced at all, Ajay, by how lucrative the whole awards game is?
Not at all. I don't do shows. I don't do awards. I don't do... There's a lot of money involved in it, but I think there are better ways to make money than just, doing anything and everything. Dancing at weddings. It's not my job. There were specialized people 100, 200 years ago doing all this. Today, actors are doing it. It's ridiculous.
Rohit, do you ever try and talk to him about going to awards?
No.
For any of your films?
I do him for All the Best. But now also I follow him. I only go if they are giving me an award. Otherwise, I do television. Why should I? Either they pay me to come for an award.
You've been paid to come for awards?
No, I tell them, either you pay me because I do television, I know how it works, or you give me an award, then only I'll go. You will never see me in an award function if they are not giving me an award, because it's all manipulated. So at least if I'm giving them 3 hours of my face for television, give me an award or give me money.
Makes sense. Tell me, what do you like most about each other now?
I don't know, because this has been a very long relationship too. It's a relationship like, after 15 years, I'm going to turn around and ask you, what do you feel about your husband? You wouldn't even know what you liked about him anymore.
I've forgotten.
Yeah, you forgot it. You forgot it.
I'm going to call him right now after the show and tell him what you said.
So you truly...
He must have also forgotten why you married him.
So you never analyze what this is about.
No, not really. Not really.
Sounds excellent. Thank you so much. I had such a good time. For more conversations like this, keep watching Film Companion.
Subscribe to the Film Companion YouTube channel now and get your film fix.